Hi everyone. I'm again really sorry for the delay. We had some technical problems, but we are going to start now. So thank you for waiting. I'm Shirina, and thank you for joining us to celebrate Wildlife Week. Today we have with us Mr. Manish Mittal sir, who is currently the Divisional Director of the Social Forestry Division in Agra, and Mr. Baidyuraj sir, who is the Director of our Conservation Projects here at Wildlife SOS. Today we'll be talking about snake identification, precautions, and rescue guidelines, after which we will have a question and answer session. So I request everyone to please put in their questions in the Q&A box and not the chat box. In case we're unable to answer your questions in the given time, we will be emailing you the answer. So please do write your email address with the questions. Now I would request Manish sir to say a few words on the occasion of Wildlife Week, and then we can begin.
Thank you, Sharina. Good morning to everyone. Special thanks to Baiju to agree to come and give a talk on snake conservation, identification of snake. Friends, as we know, every year in the first week of October, the Wildlife Week is being celebrated. And the major objective has been to make people aware of the different wildlife issues and sensitize towards them. So this year also we were doing these celebrations, and this idea of a webinar based on the rescue operations of snake came to us as we have been receiving a lot of queries and a lot of issues about snake rescue in the city of Agra and otherwise. So as all of us is aware that snakes are very, very intimidating, very attractive species because of their nature and because of fear also many times. And the whole of country, the India has around 300 species of snake, out of which only few, around 60, are poisonous to say. And all the major incidences which take place of snake bite, which are fatal, are restricted to around 4 species. But because of the fear factor, many people try to take law in hand, as snakes are covered under Wildlife Protection Act and they have been given a special protection under different schedules, under Schedule 1, 2 and 4. So the idea of this webinar is to sensitize people, to make them aware how to differentiate the most poisonous species from the non-poisonous species, and if they encounter a snake in their premises, what they should do. The Wildlife SOS in the city of Agra and around has been doing a fantastic job from last many years, and they have a dedicated helpline also, and they respond within a very short span, within a very short margin of time, and their team reaches on the spot and do the rescue. So the idea is people should not take law in hand. They should identify and they should become sensitive. So I request Baiju to take over from here and deal elaborately on the, how to differentiate different species of snake and what to do in case a snake is encountered in the premises. What are the do's and the don'ts, and what to do in case of any unfortunate incidents of snake bite. So what should be the first aid and how they should respond. Thank you, Baiju. So kindly
thank you,
take
sir.
Over, and we need to be as field oriented as possible. So our aim should be that people who encounter the snake issue should know different facets of the issue.
Thank you, sir. Shirina, can I share the screen now?
Yes, just a second. Yes, you will be able to share now.
Good morning to all. I'm Baiju, and thank you, Manish sir, for giving a good elaborative reference of to Wildlife SOS. And with Manish sir, we have many years working now since we had radio collared and released one wild bear in Suelva. Since many years, we are working with Manish sir now. So now, from Shirina and sir, we have already to understood about the topic, what we will be covering today, snake identification, precautions, and rescue guidelines. So we'll be mainly talking about these, only these topics today, because we'll not be going to a vast area. We'll be talking basic things, what we need to do, what one should do when they encounter a snake, and how fast he should react, and what he should, where he should call, whom he should call. So coming to this, MyLifeSOS founders like Geeta Sheshmani and Karthik Sathyanarayan started this organization in 1995, and we are working with n number of forest departments, states to in the field of conservation and welfare. So we are working with all these departments, which have, we had already on the slides. Because of time constriction, we'll be going little faster. So if you have questions, as Shirina told, you are most welcome to send us the questions. And I will be also talking in bilingual language, because many of the people are asked us not to be completely in English. So we'll be talking in both the Hindi and English. So as you all know, snake-human interaction, it is one of the major issue, major conflict or major interaction happening within the country. Over, like in last 10 years, we have lost 1.2 million lives in the country. And every year, 58,000 people which are reported die because of snake bite. And this is one of the major conflict which we should really look into. And when we talk about the state where we are working, Uttar Pradesh itself is 8,700 deaths were reported in the last year, in 2019. So this is the condition of our country. So we have to really look into this. And World Health Organization had already declared this as a neglected tropical disease. So it is actually not neglected tropical. It is not neglected when it comes to the poor people, because they cannot afford antivenom. They cannot go to a PHC or a what you call government hospital by the time they collapse. And out of this 58,000 snake bite death, most of this are due to Russell's viper, crate, and cobra. So this is one of the sad thing which I remember, like it's a last month's story. Mr. Bhura Singh, it's a 12-year-old boy. And when I got a call, his parents and relatives were actually crying, and they were asking, sir, can anything be done to my son? He was only a 12-year-old boy, and I feel so sad that I couldn't do anything, because the problem was they took him to a traditional healer, and by the time he reached hospital, the boy was dead. So this is in last 4 months, almost six people I know which had who are the victims and died. So there are n number of people which are not even reported. So we have to really look into this. And we always tell that please go to hospital. That is the only option for a snake bite. So this is the rescue data. If you look at the last 3 years data, and till September 30th, we are just put it into the record. We have cried Indian python, common cobra, rat snake, wolf snake, all these species we get very commonly. But now this year we are just increasing the number of cried call also. We are just putting in some of the videos. So this is a data of 3 years. You can see python, we have very good number of python. We get rat snake, we get common cobra, 15% common cobra. Then in 2018, we have 2019, we have 18% cobra. And we have again, till date, means till September 30th, we have 18% cobra already be rescued. And some of the rescues we'll be showing now in the this thing. So when we come to common snake identification, and we are basically talking about Agra. Ye Agra ka hi main baat kar raha hu actually, kyunki hum is state mein kaam karte hai, uska 15 to 16 species humne idhar rescue karte hai. Mostly we rescue 15 to 16 species of snakes which are very common. This is mainly Indian rock python. The above first picture is Indian rock python, which you can see these have good blotch marks, and they grow up to a big size. People can easily identify Indian rock python. And then come to rat snake. The bigger picture on the right hand side is a rat snake, which is one of the best friend of farmer, which we consider a best friend of farmers. And then there is a royal snake. If you see, this is a royal snake. So I'm just moving my camera here. Okay. This is royal snake, black-headed royal snake. It's a beautiful snake, but it's also a non-venomous snake. But this is commonly sighted or rescued in Agra. These are some of the other snakes which we talk about, banded kukri or common kukri, we call the left-hand side picture. This is mostly, these are all snakes because of their color and bands, they mistake into a crate and sometimes they are openly, they are killed. But as Manish sir told, we are now very, very alertly working in the field of this place where we can rescue all these snakes on a timely manner. And the other one is red sand boa. If you look at the right-hand side picture, this red sand boa. This is mostly traded species now because of false, what you call, messages spread across the country that this is for wealth and other things. These have been poached very, very frequently or very, very oftenly. And these snakes are very, very, very poor snakes and they eat only rats and they're very, very good rodent population control snakes. So we should not disturb these kind of snakes, which if there are in your garden area, they will not bite you. They eat rodents and some lizards and other things. They control a very good population of rodents within the area. And the down one is, the last one is common sand boa, we call, and it looks exactly like pythons, but it is very rough in nature. So, and it doesn't grow the size of a python. So ये सब हम इसलिए हम ये फोटो दिखा रहे हैं. When we come to the main snakes, many people had asked these questions, how can we identify some venomous snakes and non-venomous snakes? So we'll come to talk to that also now. See, so these are some of the another common snakes like wolf snake. The left hand side is a wolf snake, we call. It's a nocturnal snake and usually are found in crevices, cracks, doors, and in the kitchens because they mainly eat lizards. So they are always found and they are mistakenly killed by thinking it is a crate. And the other one is Dumeril's black-headed snake. It is very, very rarely seen. It's not to be worried at all. And these are some of the common snakes. This, the right-hand side is an ornate flying snake, which is not sighted in Agra. We had rescued from a snake charmer, and that's why we had just put this only to tell that it's a mildly venomous snake. And cat snake, the left hand side is a cat snake, and it's also a beautiful snake. They are also mildly venomous snake. We call it rare fangs. They can only kill their lizards or small prey. तो जहरीला नहीं है, दोनों mildly poisonous बोलते हैं और humans के लिए हानिकर नहीं है. और when we talk about, see people, this is mainly the big four we talk about in India, about 300 species of snakes. We consider big four. When initially I had shown the picture of the mortality rate, so most of the deaths are due to or because of these snake bites. Cobra, the first one is common cobra or spectacle cobra, we call, then it is common crate, then it is Russell's viper and saw-scaled viper. So when it comes to Agra and this region or this belt, we only find spectacle cobra and crate, common crate. So people have to only just by heart or put some posters or like what you call, you have to make it imprint in your mind these four species if spotted in your house. So you don't have to worry about 300 species of snake. We have to always worry about, okay, is it a cobra or is it a crate? Okay, I don't have to worry. This is non-venomous snake. So this is how we identify snake, because every man or sab aadmi ek scientist ke scales count karke ye iska itna scales hai utna scales hai, that is not necessary. So you just have to remember about cobra hai, crate hai. These are the markings, these are the things. And I'll also show you some of the snakelings photo also. So at least you will come to know whether it is young one, young crate, or a wolf snake. I'd put a wolf snake photo in the crate video. So you will come to know whether it is a crate or a bull snake. It is very, very easy, and we have to only think about some species which we have to identify. See, for example, this is a it is very orangish color with a black band. Suddenly people don't know. Okay, sir had told about, or Baiju had told about, this is a red sand boa. So this is a red sand boa's baby, or a snakelet we call. So what happens? Now you will, by mistake, you will tell, sir, this was a very colorful snake. So this is what you also have to know, some species like this, where young ones are entirely different in their appearance. See, for example, this is a black, common crane. It's very, very common in Agra, and very, very many of the human mortalities in Agra and Mathura are because of crane and cobra. Because recently two young kids in Mathura, Barsana area, were sleeping and the crane crawled into their bed, and both the kids died. So these are very, very, very commonly seen species. So the young one is entirely different. You can see the bands. When it grows older, the bands are distinct and it becomes nearer. And when it is young, it is like a bold snake. So people sometimes tell it is a bold snake, sometimes it is great. So you have to be worried about that as well. So this is also, left side is the young one of a royal snake. So once it grows, the black-headed royal snake, the head becomes black, the colors are distinct. So when we call black-headed royal snake to the small one, so people will think there is no black, there is no color. So you have to also think of how it is, how the young one looks. So some identification around 15 to 16 species only we have to identify if you think about Agra, this area. So we really don't have to worry about that all the species found here, all the species in this region are venomous. This is also green keelback. We don't have pictures. That's why we have to borrow it from other websites and indiansnakes.org. So this is green keelback. You can see that because these young ones are so beautiful. And in the adult one, there is no black patch at all. So it's very, very confusing sometimes. So you don't have to worry about all these snakes. These are all non-venomous snakes, which we are showing now. This is checkered keelback or paniwala samp. It is commonly in Agra and everywhere we call it paniwala samp. But there are different colors of paniwala samp. That's why we just took both the color and because of pigmentation, coloration we call. So this is the two colors you can see. And these are also the same species. There is nothing to worry, and non-venomous snakes. And usually they are seen near water bodies. So when we come to precautions to avoid snake bite, what we should do and what we should not do, what we should be taking care of. Previous also talk I had mentioned, we always think now we know that we have to wear helmets, helmet while riding, we have to wear seat belts. These are all the precautions for ourselves, to protect ourselves. So why don't you use a torch light when walking in the night? Why don't you walk with the shoes? Because many people just tell, okay, snake bit me, I was going in the dark. Why? You should use a torchlight to go out. You should use a proper footwear so you can avoid snake bites. Use a reliable flashlight. It is always better to use a flashlight. Ek flashlight use karna, ek torch use karna, bahut zaruri hai dark areas mein jaane ke time aur raat ko. Because abhi kya hua, tand ke mausam mein ya monsoon ke mausam mein, road mein thoda garam hone ke time, saamp hone ke chances jyada hai. Or us time mein, we'll encounter or we'll stamp them and it can cause harm to us. Avoid dark areas. Kyun hum raat ko jaake suddenly ek kooda rakha tha usme dhoondna shuru kar denge, because there will be rats hoga usme saamp baithega, you will be bitten. So caution while cleaning. Har cheez cleaning aur ye karne ke time aur aapka saaf safai hone ke time, please be cautious that you, which some things you are not touched for a month, sometimes there will be rats and snakes that move towards that, and snakes will be hiding there. It's only because of rats, not because to bite you. Know your snake prone area. Aapka snake prone, snake ke through aapko phobia hone ki koi zarurat nahi hai. There is nothing to worry about snakes, that everywhere you will find snake. There is nothing like that, everywhere you find snake. So you don't have to worry. first you understand whether snakes are seen in this area, snakes milta hai, nahi milta hai, then only you react to that areas. You don't have to be phobia and I wear footwear and walk every time. It's not necessary. Do not disturb a snake. This is a request to every people who find snake in their house. Please do not disturb them. Please watch them little far away. So at least we can come and rescue these snakes on a timely manner. And please, please do not imitate TV shows. TV shows are not, they are done with a very, very expert teams and they will be taking many precautions, everything. But if you start imitating these TV shows, many of the people get bitten. And I have seen myself, many, many, many rescuers had lost their lives because of imitating TV shows. They wanted to become famous. They wanted to put photos on videos on the social medias. Snake bite, you always have to think snake bites when provoked or hurt. It never bite you or come and bite you unless and until it is not hurt. Or usko kuch chot nahi laga ya aapne usko chheda khani nahi kiya usko wo kuch karega nahi. Many of the bites are by accident and wrong rescue. मैं पहले स्लाइड में भी बता रहा रॉन्ग रेस्क्यू से बहुत बहुत लोग का बहुत रेस्क्यूअर्स का डेथ हो चुका है हो रहा है अभी भी दैट इज ओनली बिकॉज़ ऑफ द शो ऑफ एंड नॉट रेस्पेक्टिंग द एनिमल नो स्नेक बाइट्स इन रिवेंज देयर इज नो रिवेंज दे डोंट कीप ग्रजेस लाइक अस वी आर द ओनली स्पीशीज हु कीप ग्रजेस एंड रिवेंज otherwise no other species keep like this so don't worry about the snake that it will bite you if you saw one snake or if you take a photo it will take that are all done in Nagin serials and movies not in the real life no snakes follow you they will never follow you or they will come to you or they will tell okay Baiju had hurt me I will come and bite Baiju after 1 month it never happens like that oh kabhi bhi दूर से आपको बाघ के काटेगा नहीं दे विल नॉट कम दे विल बी इन सिटिंग इन वन कॉर्नर दैट्स व्हाट वी आर टोल्ड टू एनी पीपल हु इन्फॉर्म और रिपोर्ट द स्नेक कॉल प्लीज स्टे अवे फ्रॉम द स्नेक एंड ऑब्जर्व द स्नेक बिकॉज़ यू नीड टू ऑब्जर्व द स्नेक बिकॉज़ दे कैन स्लिदर इट वेरी इजीली इनटू सम ऑफ द होल्स एंड सम ऑफ द अदर थिंग्स सो स्नेक बाइट व्हाट वी शुड डू इफ इज विक्टिम इज बिटन बाय अ स्नेक apply a bandage on the site because we are told in many videos and many videos you can get in online and the internet also it's all very common thing you have to you have also always have to put a bandage don't tie it or tight things because if you block the artery you may get paralyzed and that may be cause of another damage what you will be doing to yourself so kabhi bhi bahut zyada उसको क्या बोलता है टाइट में बांधना नहीं है हल्का बांधना है और मूवमेंट रेस्ट्रिक्ट करना है और उसके बाद एक अभी बाय चांस हाथ में काट लिया एक प्लिंथ और एक सॉरी स्प्लिंट रखना चाहिए एक लकड़ी का और उसके बाद बांधना है वो लूज भी होगा और उसके अलावा ये मूवमेंट भी कम होगा वॉकिंग और रनिंग शुड बी अवॉइडेड दौड़ना और वॉक करना कम करना है और विक्टिम को कभी भी स्नेक काट लिया तो उसको जल्दी से जल्दी कोई भी आपके साधन मिल रहा है उसको हॉस्पिटल लेके जाना बहुत जरूरी है और हाथ में काट लिया तो आप एक स्लिंग में डाल दिया तो इट विल बी बेटर बिकॉज द मूवमेंट विल बी रेस्ट्रिक्टेड द लेस मूवमेंट द लेस वेनम विल बी व्हाट यू कॉल ट्रैवलिंग So what you should know and what should you avoid and what you should do things like you should never like do not panic, do not make any cut or scratch or incision. Why? Because the main thing is you may get tetanus and that will be again cause a problem. Tetanus ho jayega koi chaku leke aaya koi blade leke aaya kaat liya to aur problem ho jayega kabhi zyada kaatne ke liye vein kaatne ke liye ye sab karta hai. Do not suck the wound. कोई किसी को सांप काट लिया आपने उसको सक कर लिया मैं खून चूस के उसका जहर निकाल लूंगा दैट इज अनदर डेंजरस थिंग फॉर यू योर सेल्फ बिकॉज आपके माउथ में कोई भी एक अल्सर हो इट विल बी ईजी फॉर योर डेथ देन द विक्टिम्स डेथ अप्लाई आइस पैक नहीं लगाना है टाइट बैंडेज और टॉर्निक्यू नहीं बांधना और अल्कोहल हर्बल मेडिसिन और ये पेन किलर्स नहीं देना चाहिए दैट विल ऑल इफेक्ट एडवर्सली सो इट इज What you should do is stay calm, don't panic, and take the victim to hospital. That is the only and only solution for a snake bite. If it is a dry bite and non-venomous snake bite, you can easily save him from a traditional healer. That is the trick they use or the knack they use. But really, if it is bitten by a poisonous venomous snake, you should be going to a hospital. There is no venom serum has been made, and reach the hospital as soon as possible, basically killing the snake and going to the hospital, because all these are antivenom is if a cobra bite also same antivenom is given, a Russell's viper also, the common crate also, and Zoskill viper also, this is the same antivenom. Even recently we had we had coordinated for a bite in Jammu Kashmir with our team working in Jammu Kashmir with the same antivenom. A Levantine viper treatment was also done with 6 or 10 vials. So it is we always have to reach to hospital. That is the best option available in the country. So coming to snake rescue, this is the last part of our presentation. So before coming to snake rescue, I will like to share what are the laws and what are the complications happening today in our country. You can just imagine, these are some of the pictures from the internet source. You can see some people have been arrested because of a bottle and they were keeping sand boas or other things. The first photo is from a Sapera. You can see how much damage they are doing to the ecosystem by collecting these snakes for Naga Panchami and other things. And people, snake rescuers, so-called snake rescuers, keep the snakes like very unprofessional manner like that. Do you really think that आप ऐसे सोच सकते हैं इसका हड्डी नहीं है, इसको मोड़ मुड़ा के गुरा के उसको एक बॉटल में रखो, आप देखो पेप्सी के बॉटल में, इसके बॉटल में, उसके बॉटल में, अचार के बॉटल में, ऐसे रखना बहुत बहुत गैर कानूनी है. मोस्ट ऑफ द स्नेक्स कम अंडर वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट, लाइक एग ईटिंग स्नेक, पाइथन्स आर कमिंग अंडर शेड्यूल 1 एंड अदर स्नेक्स आर कमिंग अंडर शेड्यूल 2. एंड इफ रियली इफ यू हैड बीन बुक्ड, यू कैन इजीली गो टू जेल फॉर एटलीस्ट 3 years. सो यू हैव टू बी केयरफुल. Please rescue in a proper way, not like this bottle mein bhar ke rakh diya aur 10-15 saamp rakh diya, saath mein ek saath chodenge. That also you are doing a very injustice and illegal thing to the snake. These are the things you should always remember, the rescuers especially. If you are rescuing a snake, it should be in a proper way. Inform the forest department or a call from the forest department, it is always good. Now recently, you know, in Kerala, there had been a new mandate came and the government had ordered clearly, and a certificate will be issued to all the rescuers. Some people who don't have a certificate as a rescuer cannot rescue a snake. He will be booked. It's now officially announced, and as a government order has come in Kerala, it will be followed to all the states now because of this mishandling and mismanagement of these snake rescues. You can see this. This is a snake charmer snake which we had rescued from Agra. They are from with full of pus in the nose and mouth. All the fangs were defanged. And these are the condition of Nag Panchami. We pray to Shivji because he had been keeping snakes. This is not that. If you really want to worship, you should worship the Lord and also the snake, but not in this manner. Taking and giving milk and forcing it to drink milk, keeping it thirsty. These are the condition of the snake charmers, where we worship and give money so much to the saperas. So you can see one more snake we had caught, rat snake. This is how this is a mongoose hairbread stitched into the scale of the rat snake. Just imagine, these are the torture they do to the snakes. So please don't encourage this kind of things. Aap isko jyada badhava ya motivation nahi dena chahiye. और नाग पंचमी वैसे इसमें आप शिव जी को या नाग को वर्शिप करो, नॉट विद द रियल स्नेक्स. सो कमिंग टू स्नेक रेस्क्यू अगेन, वी हैव सम वेरी गुड टूल्स और इक्विपमेंट instruments which we should be using. We will be showing the video now. And when we talk about that, we can see that these are some of the equipment we use. We have a bag and a pipe, which is the safest method to rescue a snake. We have a hook to lift the snake and put, and we also have a tong. Basically, we don't suggest to use the tong because it depends on the people how you pressure. If you press it more hard, there is a what you call, you can damage the bones of the snake. So it is not that advisable to use these kind of things. Tong aap use kar sakte hain, aap utna accha se usko handle kar sakta to. Otherwise, don't use that. Respect your life. हर रेस्क्यूअर से हमारा एक विनती है, आप अपने लाइफ को रेस्पेक्ट करो, स्नेक के लाइफ को रेस्पेक्ट करो. अदरवाइज व्हाट हैपेंस इज, इफ यू डोंट रेस्पेक्ट योर लाइफ एंड द लाइफ ऑफ द स्नेक, यू विल नॉट बी अ रेस्क्यूअर. एंड अ रेस्क्यू इज नॉट कंप्लीटेड व्हेन द स्नेक इज रिलीज्ड इन अ नेचुरल हैबिटेट, और इफ यू थिंक इट इज अ हैबिटेट, बिकॉज कीपिंग इन अ बॉटल इज नॉट अ रेस्क्यू. वी शुड नॉट एनकरेज दिस काइंड ऑफ रेस्क्यू. वो एक रेस्क्यू नहीं है, उसको खाली अपने पर्सनल इंटरेस्ट के लिए आप बॉटल में भर के सांप को रख रहे हैं. कमिंग टू दिस, यू कैन सी सम ऑफ द वीडियोस. आई डोंट नो हाउ इट विल प्ले बिकॉज़ वी हैव मेनी अटेंडीज. सो दिस इज हाउ वी जस्ट हैंडल द स्नेक. इट इज अ वेनमस कोबरा. यू कैन सी वी जस्ट हैव टू गाइड इट टू व्हाट यू कॉल इनटू अ पाइप एंड अ बैग. इट विल इजीली गो इनटू द बैग. वी डोंट रियली नीड टू worry about the snake or handle. We need to have little courage, but I'm not asking this to do everyone. We have given some volunteers and forest people training, so they can easily do that. It is very easy to rescue a snake rather than beating and killing the snake. So this is the kind of rescues we should be carrying out. You can see our rescuers how easily it is going. We just have to be. This is a pipe and bag method, which is very commonly used. You should be wary. We have a good rescue team in Agra working with us, and also in Delhi and Gujarat. We do a lot of snake rescues in this manner. So these are some of the things which we had kept. This was in a bed, you can see. Snakes can go to anywhere. It is not like that it will be only on the ground or living. It's a big cobra. So we just have to lift the snake and just guide it to a dark hole. It will easily go. You can see that. You don't really need to do anything to a snake rescue. And you don't have to show off, take it in hand or anything. This is some of the videos are there from Kerala also, which I had put it, because we don't have to worry about that, because whether it is Kerala, Bengal or India, Delhi or Jammu Kashmir or wherever, the snake, the method should be same, because we don't have to really handle the snake, torture the snake or make snake what we call for photography or videography. You can easily rescue a snake because we are doing a noble cause. So it should act as a good thing. And you will not give your car or a bike or anything to a driver who had met with the accident for 25 times. So a person who had bitten by a snake 10 times is not a good rescuer. The person who had bit the least will be considered as the best rescuer. So this is a python rescue. You can see it is very simple how to handle pythons also, but we need to have a proper equipment. You can just keep it in front. And this is a bag. People think that how pythons can be rescued. So it is very, very common rescues and how we can do. This is a night rescue, you can see. This is like a ditch. So what we call, we have to just divert. It is not necessary that you have to handle the python, hold the python up in the air or something. Or but there are situations. It is not like that. We should not do. If he is a good handler and if you are not going to damage the animal, you can rescue it. It is some areas we can rescue it very nicely. Because we have to rescue it with hand. You can see that it is without touching that animal. Can easily go into a bag. And this is some of the conditions we get, see this, this is a cobra rescue, and this their right side is a rat snake. Here we can't use pipe and bag method. Okay, so we have to put our hand. We have to be worried about this. Otherwise, we can't help it, because some rescues are done with hand only, bare hand. This you can imagine. This is a recent rescue in last week. A crate inside the toilet, and it's in a western seat, and it was very, very dangerous. Our rescuers have to completely take out the seat to rescue that. So this is a crate. So we have to be very careful. This is how we rescue. It's a very dangerous snake. If it is bitten, you or me or any of the staff also have to go to hospital. There will be no other option. This, you can just imagine where the crate is sitting. It is inside the kitchen, what you call platform. It was inside. It is a very good thing that the house people had noticed that it's like almost 4.5 feet it was. It was a very, very long crate. And it was in the middle of the night. We got a call, and we had to go, and our team had to go and rescue it. So it's, you can see the size. So long it was. And this is Taj Mahal. It was just in the police booth. It was a rat snake again. So the some snakes we have to handle with care, and sometimes we have to handle with bare hand. It is not like everywhere we can keep the bag and the pipe method. Sometimes we have to use this also. So this is a rat snake. The way you handle, so they will also understand. It's not necessary that this is the last video which we have. You can just see, we don't even have to touch the snake. It just guide the snake into the bag and pipe. This is the best method if you can do. If you have a hook, just guide the snake into the pipe and the bag. It will be easily done, and there is nothing to worry that it will bite or it will do. But this all, everyone can do this, but you have to be careful. And it is not what we are told that you do rescue snake, but it is not the way we are going to tell. I'm ऐसे नहीं बोल रहा आप कर सकते हैं मतलब आपके पास वो will power भी होना चाहिए थोड़ा अक्षमता भी होना चाहिए. This is the size of the cobra we rescued yesterday night. Such a big cobra. So this is the crate rescue which I was telling, and you can see this is a crate. It's a common crate. It's inside the bedroom. You can see a boy is even sitting on the bed. You can see that in the video now. He's on the bed, so he didn't want to even come out, and it is very, very risky. And these are all in the middle of the night. You can see that boy. So these are the things. You can see the size of the crate. Because nowadays we are getting lot of crates from Agra, बहुत crates हमको मिलता है. तो जनता से ये विनती है आप उसको कुछ चढ़कानी मत करिएगा, हमको call करते. And right hand side is the photo of a common bull snake. That's why purposely I put that. ये snake बहुत mistaken होके मार जाता है क्योंकि ये bull snake है. इसका brown color होता है और band होता है. ये बिल्कुल जहरीला नहीं होता है और बिल्कुल डरने की जरूरत भी नहीं है. So इसका ये इसलिए मैंने ये photo इसमें specially लगाया है. And this is so snakes in the ecosystem, everybody know snakes play a crucial role in maintaining rodent population, and snakes are considered as the best rodent population. Why? Because they are the only and they are the best possible, they are the best possible predator that they can go into the hole and catch the rat compared to any other rat eaters like dogs, cats or any other rat eaters. If you take the snakes are the best adapted species who can go inside the hole and control your rodent population. So they play very, very important. बहुत ecosystem के लिए बहुत बहुत जरूरी है. और इसके this is the last slide. And we also have our many episodes in India's Jungle Heroes by Nat Geo Wild. You can all log in. आप log in कर सकते हैं. आप Disney Hotstar में हमका rescues देख सकते हैं. हमारा team को देख सकते हैं. You can mail us. And also, you can join us Wildlife Associates Reptile Rescue page on Facebook. Mein hai. You can join the Reptile Rescue page Wildlife Associates, especially meant for reptile lovers and snake lovers. And we also have Delhi and Zar mein, we have a helpline number. We have in Agra two helpline numbers, and even in Gujarat. we have. And also we work in Jammu and Kashmir, Srinagar areas. We have a full-time rescue and unit working on. We rescue a lot of Levantine viper there and other snakes like trinket and other rat snakes. So thank you all for watching our program. I hope you will have questions. Abhi question answers mein aap pooch sakte hai, or if time permits, we can answer all questions. Hum answer kar sakte hai. Aur uske alawa kisi ko humko direct contact karna to, you can always call us, mail us and ask us all. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, Baiju sir. You can unshare the screen now. Thank you, Manish sir. Would you like to say a few words before we get on to the Q&A? Manish sir, you're on mute.
I'll just add one or two things, two observations as far as rescue operations of snakes are concerned. Generally, I've seen that people try to follow the snakes in their burrows when they are following and try to catch hold of snakes by their tail. And they forgot that when snakes go inside their burrows, they stick their head at the opening of the burrow and then take the tail inside. So in case you put your hand in, then you are straight away, you know, exposing yourself to his flanks. And that is one of the mistakes which commonly I have seen people making. And the best thing is whenever you see a is to instead of eating things in your own hand. I think that is it from me. And if there are some specific queries, then we are here to answer.
Yes. So we have received quite a lot of questions, but we will try to answer as many as we can.
We can send this afterwards also. We can.
Yes. So one question is, how is it possible to identify individual species through fang marks?
Okay, one second. I'm just minimizing this. What is that question? Through fang marks?
Yes.
But we don't have to identify through fang marks. It depends, because if it is like last presentation we had that fang marks, if it is a cobra or any venomous snake bite, there will be two distinct fangs mark first and remaining small teeth marks. So you cannot identify a snake through fang marks. I really doubt that. Because crate bite, we can't even make out the point. It will be very minute points, the fang marks. And if it is a big cobra or a Russell swiper, we can make the two distinct marks.
And could you provide some information about the anti-venom availability and effectiveness of anti-venoms in UP?
Anti-venoms are available very much. Anti-venom both, it is a Hindi question or an English question, Serena?
English question.
So anti-venoms are very much available in UP. We also have collected and kept. We have very good reliable source. If anybody want, we can even give the rest of the people. And in government hospital, it is available. Government SN Medical College, it is treatment is happening. There is nothing to worry about anti-venom. But the problem is we have to reach on time to the hospital. It is available in UP.
Majority of community health centers also, Baiju.
Yes.
Community health centers have this facility, and it is being strictly monitored by the government also that their availability is ensured.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. If a snake is found in a residential area, where is the suitable place to release it in case we cannot reach the forest department?
See, it is better to release where people are not if you don't have to release a snake in a evergreen forest. I always tell people like that, or in a sanctuary, any undisturbed area. If a barren area also will be a snake habitat, there will be snakes living there because they'll be eating lizards and all. If it's not like that, all it has to be green. So if it is any undisturbed human area, undisturbed area by humans, it will be better to release that area. Just any nearby forest or nearby what you call water area or anywhere you can release, but it's provided it should not be disturbed by humans. because if there also work is going on, it is again, it will be, you are creating another conflict.
Right. Okay, thank you. Can a non-venomous snake eat a venomous snake?
Definitely they can eat. I had seen myself sand boa eating a cobra in Kerala, but the problem is eat is a question, or is there any venom or some
there
problem?
Yes, the follow-up the question problem, is, in case it happens, is the venom from the venomous snake fatal for the non-venomous snake?
It is somewhat fatal only for any animal, but the issue happens is it depends on the wound. Sometimes what happened, many of the time, if a sand boa or any snake catch a snake to eat a prey, it catch by a head, because so that time they cannot bite them. So most of the time they can they don't get bitten. They hold them tightly till they die and then eat them.
How do we break the conflict between humans and pythons? Recently, within 1 month, 2 big pythons were killed by people. We are working here as rescuers, but they still kill pythons. This is one of the questions we got.
The problem, yeah, bahut problem. This is the problem. This is also English, right?
Yes. All are.
The problem between snake conflict is people have so much misconception. Actually, they will, what do you call, recently in UP only we had heard about this, because the thing is they doubt that it had completely swallowed a baby or a kid. That was the issue. And they had to kill and they strangled that, and then they came to know it was a lamb or some goat. So this condition, people have a belief that we need to do a lot of awareness program in this case, that pythons are not like this, because many of the people consider Anaconda as the movie, because in that it's just like a snake following people, but that never happens with the python. If you only when it is handled or you are holding a python, it will try to bite. Otherwise python don't come and bite. That is the first thing. Awareness is very, very important. Once awareness is done in the villages, they will not kill, because we can easily convince them.
Right. And a similar question, many snakes, both venomous and non-venomous, are killed under the pretense of self-defense. Can these killings be booked under the Wildlife Protection Act? Maybe Manish sir, you can also act.
Yeah, sure. Even, you know, catching hold or doing a rescue operation gets classified under the Section 9 of the Wildlife Protection Act. So if anybody who is rescuing need to have a authority and the permission from the Forest Department before rescuing. So if somebody, you know, is catching hold of a venomous snake or a non-venomous snake is without authority, he can be booked. Other thing is, once he is booked and it is proven in investigation that event of, you know, killing that venomous or non-venomous snake was done in self-defense, then he can be, you know, the penalties can be relaxed to a certain extent. Otherwise, that self-defense has to be proven. And if it is not proven, he will be booked very stringently, and minimum punishment of 3 years is provisioned for that. So nobody should take, law in hand. They should straight away reach the Forest Department. They should not do any rescue operations on their own. They should not, you know, try to do, if they see an snake in the house or in the premises, they should keep themselves and other family members away from the snake. Call the department people, they will come and rescue it.
Thank you, sir. Another question is, what should one do if anyone is bitten by a venomous snake but lives far from the hospital, so 3-4 hours away? So what should they do till they reach the hospital?
The first aid, basic first aid I told you, because if they can tie a bandage, make the victim calm. 3-4 hours is also fine. When we reach the hospital, it is not a problem, but you should try to reach hospital. The doctors can, from last 8 hours also, some of my friends, doctors are there in Pune and all. They had even revived or retrieved people after reaching 8 hours also. It is not a condition. The patient should be calm. He should not be this thing, and first aid means tie this thing, tie a bandage, and not make him move or run or walk. Take him in a bike or car, whatever possible, as soon as possible to hospital. But usually, I don't think like Manish sir told, every PHCs are also, public health centers are also mandatory to keep antivenoms. So it is better to understand about this also. Recently, one of our staff's wife got bitten by a snake in Shivpuri. So we initially told them first to ask the PSCs and government hospital whether medicines are available. So once he have to go from Agra to reach there, by the time we found out that the PSCs and government hospitals have the medicines or the anti-venom. That is what one should do.
I think, Beju, the additional problem is, you know, people generally try to find the local solutions.
Yes, exactly.
And they waste the time in that. The first thing, if you think a snake has bitten you, you should not waste any time. You should straight away think and work to take the patient to the hospital, to the nearest hospital. Because, you know, approaching the local doctors or the local quacks is not the solution to this issue. I have seen in the villages, you know, people think that local quacks can take care of this. But as you know, majority of these snakes are non-venomous. So whatever the local applications they use, that work. So to say that work, because majority of the cases, the snake is non-venomous. In case the snake is venomous, then these local solutions do not work. So nobody should take any chance. They should straight away take to the hospital. And as you said, a local bandage application to minimize the movement of that particular affected limb or the, you know, hand or leg portion. That is the most important, and keeping the patient cool so that he is not under stress. I think that is the only way out in case snake bite happens to someone.
Thank you, sir. Another question is it true that king cobras are immune to their own venom?
Maybe possible. I am not 100% sure about that. I have not worked much in that. I can find out and get the answers to them, because I had not worked on this system, so I am not. I cannot answer this question, because I may have to ask my herpetology friends. So I can get back to them with this answer.
Okay. This is one question which came in Hindi, but we've translated it. How do you take action against those who get treatment in the name of jharphook and those who earn money via snakes in religious places and snake charmers?
So, uske liye you have to take the call. The snake bite victim have to, or victim's family have to take a call. I recently told last moment mein ye bache ka families. It is just 1.5 kilometer from our center. 3 ghante ke baad wo humko call karke pooch rahe hai, they are asking ki bacche ko kya kar sakta hai. So as Manish sir told, unka belief ye hai us healer ne 50 log ko bachaya, ek bacche ne mara. So the reality is that bachcha only was bitten by a venomous snake. Rest all were non venomous snake. So it is from the victim's family or the members, whether they want to go there or this, we cannot help in that case, because everybody have their own business and they do that. We cannot come into somebody's business, and why you are doing that, we cannot ask at all.
Right. Manish sir, do you
want otherwise also, but I'll add to it. See, all doctors and the practitioners need to be registered, and the government has a proper system of registration. And generally, these quacks who, you know, work at the villages level, they are not registered. They do not have any degrees of medical practitioners. So anybody who finds that, you know, a quack is working in the field, he can file an FIR with the police department and also intimate the district health department, the CMO concerned, that he is working. And the CMO is empowered to take action against them.
Thank you, sir. Okay. Another one is by a veterinarian, actually. He says, I find many road kills of snakes. Can we preserve them using formaldehyde, or do we need permission to do the same?
They may need
any wild animal. They certainly require a permission. See, preserving a wild animal is also covered under the Wildlife Protection Act. And once an animal dies, it automatically becomes a government property. The animal might have died because of the roadkill or because of any other incidents. So you cannot keep a government property in your custody without a proper permission. And so the question of keeping it in formaldehyde for any use doesn't apply unless until they have a proper permission. Those permissions are generally given only for research purposes, and the concerned chief wildlife warden of the state is empowered to give the permission.
Last two questions. How are the various pollutants, so air pollution, water pollution, affecting the native snake population in India?
If you consider about any pollution, there are n number of species vanishing because of pollution. Snakes have like water pollution, air pollution, any pollution will be a cause for there are many causes for the snakes. If it is water is polluted, they cannot go in the water because many of them need water. And if it is like oily, something oil, like for example, I'm telling you, we rescued a python which was fell in a pool, like a drainage, which was an oil, what you call, so much oil was there draining in that, and it was completely covered with oil. So the complete movement was restricted. It was like almost like dead. So, and we even the vets don't apply any oil-based medicine to snakes, because they have so much sensory organs, like they breathe, all these things. That's why they mold. So if something happened to their skin, they can die. So these kind of pollutions will affect definitely to them. And also in the air, they smell from the air. First of all, they can't see far, they smell through air. So if air is pollutant, their feeding habitat will disturb. All this can happen through air pollution because they will not get proper smell where they want to or which animal they want to prey on.
Right. Thank you, sir. One question, we've actually received multiple questions, similar questions. People are asking how they can become a rescuer. Are there any training centers in India to get trained? Do they need some permissions, any registrations? We've received over 20-25 questions of this.
Actually, rescuers, mainly people work with NGOs and forest department. Now, there are many which hired myself, seen many of the forest department themselves are hiring people, good rescuers. Once they are trained from any NGOs or some professional people, they can definitely apply to forest department, because even in Uttarakhand forest department, they had hired 5-10 people for rescuers, for snake rescue, other animal rescue. So people are hiring because the conflict in India, because of habitat degradation and other things, are increasing. The conflict is increasing. There nowhere it is decreasing. So there will be n number of chances for the rescuers if he or she is a good rescuer. It's not like only for a namesake rescuer putting in the bottle. If they are a scientific rescuer, there will be always option or opportunities for them if they are a good rescuer. And definitely forest department, zoo authorities, zoos, all are promoting this kind of volunteering, what you call rescue works, and also hiring people for rescue. So this is a good opportunity, but the thing is, we have to go in a correct direction. It should not be like for Facebook or social media, like only for that rescue. And that will end up in a bad name for the rescuer as well as the officer who is going to take him. So we'll be definitely looking into that. Definitely we are hiring volunteers. We will have volunteers. Agra also, we have some volunteers. Many places we have volunteers working with us, where we come to know whether they can rescue snake. That people, we definitely give them a call. Tell them, okay, you rescue. And we really need to know whether they rescue. We have to be monitoring them. We will monitor them. That's how our rescuer is made. It through dedication.
But like Manish sir, does the forest department give any proper training? Is there some training center or online?
No. As far as state of Uttar Pradesh goes, we do not have any training centers yet. What we are having is the MOUs with different NGOs. And generally, the people who are interested in rescue operations, they join these NGOs, and over a period of time, you know, they become good rescuers. And then either they continue with the working with the NGO, or, you know, start up their, you know, a different branch. So as far as state of Uttar Pradesh is concerned, we do not have any center as yet.
And the same,
but, you know, the big centers in South, like say Madras Crocodile Bank, where, you know, there they have some training courses. in the state of Uttar Pradesh we don't have.
And Baiju sir, does Wildlife SOS have any training course, or are we planning to start?
Yes, we definitely give training to people. The problem is we need dedicated people. We are definitely most of what you call our most of our rescuers are the community, the Sapera communities. We have rehabilitated them. We have changed this community from indigenous to scientific rescuers. We had made them. So we can definitely make people into a good rescuers, a passionate or compassionate person. See, it is not only for a rescue of an animal. We should have compassion, or we should have passion towards the work. Then only he or she can become a rescuer. And Wildlife SOS is definitely giving training programs. Even with Forest Department, we had done many, many training programs. Even last time also in Van Vihar National Park, we had done a training program for Forest Department. So wherever possibilities, Wildlife SOS will jump into provide training, because we need more rescuers to help more animals. That is what we always believe.
So I think we're out of time now. We have a few unanswered questions, but we will reply to everyone with their email ID on their email. So if you have any more questions, you can keep writing them down in the chat box.
I saw some question about Salasar pit viper. Somebody had asked.
Yes,
Salasar. It is actually today morning only in CZA group we had got one Salasar pit viper, which from North Bengal area. So it's a new discovered species, everybody know, because of Harry Potter. So much is on the internet. Whoever is interested, he can log on. Today morning only they rescued one and released in the jungle. So we just confirmed it was a Salasar pit viper.
Great. Manish sir, any end note that you'd like to say?
I think Baiju has covered maximum things, and the esteemed attendees have, you know, asked very relevant questions. And I hope that this interaction with them, we can continue, and we can organize further educative programs. As I could see, there has been demand of, you know, conducting more educative programs for children also, in one of the chats on the same. So I think we'll continue this. It's a good way to start an interaction. So I thank Wildlife SOS for coming forward and, you know, spreading the information and the awareness, and continue the good work.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, everyone joining. Have a good Sunday.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, thank you.